Hercules! Hercules! What's up, YouTube? It's Mitch Santona here with X-Graver. X-Graver is part of the Hercules Project. Hercules is a giant looking devastator creature. This guy is not Scavenger. He is X-Graver. This is not a Hasbro product. This is actually made by the TFC Toys company, who is a third-party transformer company, if you will. He forms the right arm of Hercules. Also this, and a very interesting note, I guess, from what I've been reading, the hand, which I see here, it's just pretty darn big. That hand is going to fit underneath him, so you can store all the accessories on his person without having to have a bag full of extra junk. Pretty cool. Let's pop this dude open. So everybody, this is the X-Graver out of his package, and he is an awesome Generation 1-esque. It's like an updated G1 big-ass Constructicon, and I like this thing a lot. I've played with him for a few minutes here, and I don't have many complaints. He's cool. He's very heavy. All of his joints are very tight. Everything works. He's got pistons here. This swivels. And he's got a lot of ports all over the place for different weapon positions and different options. Like if you don't like these guns up here, you can put them here. You can put them. There's like three holes here. A very interesting transformation too. There's a couple elements which I haven't seen before, which is kind of cool and refreshing, and I do like that. But yeah, he's got like some silver expanded metal painted on him here. The purple is nice. The green is a very nice color. These are like a grayish black. They're not quite black, but they look metallic almost, and they look very nice. And that is the hand. That's the Hercules hand, or the Devastator hand, if you will. It's covering up his face, which is hidden behind there. But yes, it is part of his vehicle mode. So you can have all of the necessary components to make the Hercules, or the arm, rather, for Devastator. And without having, you know, to go find a box full of goodies. They're all on him. So this is very cool. He rolls. He's got some wheels under here. Yeah, can't say enough good stuff. Let me get him transformed. Let me show you what he came with, though, too.
Nice set of color instructions here. Shows you very clearly what to do. He's got excellent artwork. Whoever did that, really very, very nice. On their behalf, Hercules X-Graver, got your warnings, all that good stuff. And then on the back, it's robot. On the front, it's robot to excavator mode. And then on the back, it's, I think, just excavator mode to arm mode. So that's kind of nice. Inside of his box, this is nice too. You can pretty much display him if you so choose. He's got some really cool artwork in the back of the box. It says X-Graver on the side with the, warning yellow and black stripes here. So that's kind of neat too. And then he even comes with a tech spec card, which I thought was cool too. Again, really good artwork. If you want to read his tech specs, that's what they read. And let's get him back in frame. I'm gonna do something I haven't done in a while. Let's do a little transformation montage. I love him. I like it a lot. This is excellently done. The engineering is good. It's quite nice. The transformation is kind of unique, where you take his cab off and you put it over here. He's got a couple of geared, like his feet are geared, which is kind of nice. They close and open at the same time. I found that I dig that. a ton of posability on this thing. It's awesome. Check this out. The head is on a glorious, glorious ball joint. This guy can look everywhere. I mean, look, he's just gazing up into the sky. He can do it flat-footed. The head is very G1-esque, and I like that about it as well. Light piping is glorious. I don't know if it's going to really pipe out here. You're not going to be able to see it too well, but that's just a close-up shot of the head. And he looks cool. He looks like he's got a paintball mask on or something. That looks nice. But articulation everywhere. He's got swivel here. He's got swivel here. He's got additional swivel here, plus additional rotation there. Bend at the elbow. His hands will swivel. His head, we already noted, is glorious. He's got a ratcheting waist, which is beautiful. Ball joints on the hips, upper thigh swivel, knee joints, no swivel at the ankles, but he does have some pivoting action in his feet. But with all that other posability, there is, I mean, I would give this a 10 overall in articulation because it is solid. So they managed to take a blocky G1 looking figure and make it articulate and make it fall and make it look dynamic. And I think I am in love. I like this a lot, man. And I know I've been gushing a lot in my last reviews. I haven't had a lot of bad things to say, but I've been waiting a long time for a lot of these things to come out, and I haven't been disappointed in any of them. I think this is cool. Now, you can take this off as well. If you don't like that look, I like it. I think it looks like a scorpion of some sort. And it's really heavy, too. And the cool thing about it is his legs are so strong that it doesn't topple him over, even though I just whacked him down there. But you can pull this off, and then he can use it. He's got a lot of ports, like, all over him as well. You see all these portholes on his arms and such. And then, gosh, I just love dropping expensive toys all over the place. But then you can use this as his, like, a grabby claw, like a some sort of nasty weapon. And he stands with it, no problems. That's heavy, and he's holding it up like nothing. Arms got the strength to do it. Legs got the strength to do it. He's got great balance. Excellent figure. Excellent, excellent figure. So, overall, I give this thing a 10 out of 10. But that is strictly my opinion. I don't give it a 10 out of price. It's expensive. It's a little too expensive. If these guys were like $60 a piece, I think this it'd be a little bit more. I think I'd love it even more, actually, but I think they're a bit overpriced. It really does have some decent quality. There's no complaints there. Everything about it, I like. I think it's a very well done figure. I do. $100 is expensive though. So, you know, if you can swing it and you like G1 Devastator, then I think this will be right up your alley because it's right up mine. That's it. This has been Mitch Santona. I do give this one of my highest ratings. I'm extremely, extremely excited to bring you all of them because I will be collecting the entire lot. I believe there will be 5 more of these guys. And then we will have ourselves a big building party where we get Hercules or the Not Devastator together. And I may do a backflip for the first time in my life on film. Maybe. Crap, that's a big arm.